see this from the Sylvian point, okay, so or the periauricular point, or it's also known as perion also. So from this point, so now the stem of lateral sulcus, so it will split into three branches or the three rami or the three division, okay. So now, so the three divisions, so one division, so it will run horizontally in the anterior aspect, one will run so upward and one will run backward. So they have got a name, anterior horizontal rami. Then next is the anterior ascending rami, and next is the posterior rami of lateral sulcus. So the anterior horizontal rami of lateral sulcus, anterior ascending rami of lateral sulcus, and the posterior rami of lateral sulcus. So now see from this point, so you can see the division. So one which is running horizontally forward, so that is the anterior horizontal rami of lateral sulcus. One run upwards, so that is the anterior ascending rami. Okay, and the next, so that will run backward, so that is the posterior rami of lateral sulcus. So this point of division, so that is the Sylvian point, periauricular point, or perion. Okay, so perion, the same thing. Perion or periauricular. Preauricular. Preauricular point or the Sylvian point. So the same thing. Okay, just remember. Now see here. So this sulcus or this fissure, okay, so it the stem will divide the so orbital and the tangential. Okay, so that means the so it separates the frontal from the temporal. Okay, so and see if you see the this posterior rami of lateral sulcus, so it separates the so parietal from the temporal also, okay, and also from the frontal from the temporal also, okay. So little narrative. So see, so regarding the lobe, okay, so like that. So next is the, now let's know the next, then I'll draw the diagram, okay, so to understand the sulcus again. So now see, so next is the parieto-occipital. So this parieto-occipital, so that is the sulcus of medial. So this is the medial surface, isn't it? So this medial surface. So this medial surface. So now see here, you can see one sulcus. Okay. So this is the calcarine sulcus. Okay. Now this sulcus. So begin from the center or the midpoint of the calcarine sulcus and more on upward, okay, so and reaches the superior medial border. Okay, so cut the superior medial border. So this border is the superior medial border. So now up to here it will reach. Okay, so this is the medial surface. So this surface, so this is the lateral surface. So this is the medial view and this is the lateral view. So this is the lateral view, this is the medial view. Okay, so in the medial view, so you can see this sulcus. So that is the parieto-occipital sulcus. So it begins from the midpoint of the calcarine sulcus and it will run upward and reaches, finally cuts the superior medial border. So the superior medial border, so it will reach, it will cut here. And then, so this cutting point, so it lies almost 5 cm in front of the occipital pole. So from the occipital pole, so 5 cm in front, okay, so the parieto-occipital sulcus cuts the that is the superior medial border. So it's not only superior border, so this is the superior medial border. Medial is also required here. So superior medial border. Okay, are you getting? So this is the parieto-occipital sulcus. Now see, so if you see, so this sulcus and the border sulcus. So now this sulcus, so it is not going to completely divide the so its cerebral hemisphere into different lobe. Okay, so still some other so imaginary line are required. Okay, so now let me draw first that thing. So let me draw this main. Okay, so now you see here. Okay, so see if you, so I'll draw the both view here. Okay, so suppose, so here is, this is the lateral view. Okay, so lateral view, so here is the frontal pole, suppose. Okay, so here is the frontal pole, So this is the superior. So suppose, okay, so this is the superior lateral surface, okay, or the lateral view. And see, so let me draw the next view. So that is the medial view also. So suppose here is the medial view. Okay, so the medial surface is more visible in this. Okay, so let me draw like this. So now here is the corpus callosum. So you see in the medial surface, the corpus callosum is here, suppose. So now here is the fornix is there. So now let me draw the calcarine sulcus here. So suppose this is the calcarine sulcus. Okay, suppose this is the calcarine sulcus. Now let me draw the major sulcus. Okay, so we have it up to now. So now see, so this is the frontal pole. Here is the occipital pole. So similarly in this also, so here is the occipital pole. So here is the frontal pole. And in this view, so you can even see the temporal pole also. Okay, so now see, so the central sulcus, so just you have to take the midpoint between the frontal and the occipital pole. So somewhere here maybe, the midpoint. And see this central sulcus, it begins behind this midpoint only. So almost 1.2 centimeter behind this midpoint. Okay, so from here the central sulcus will begin and it will run downward, forward and laterally. So like this. Okay, so this is the central sulcus. Okay, now the lateral sulcus. So let me draw the inferior view also. So here is the, suppose here, this one. So here is the orbital surface. So suppose this is the tentorial surface. So just the rough diagram. So here is the frontal pole. And this is the occipital pole. So now see, so this is just the rough diagram. Okay, so this is the lateral view. This is the inferior view. And this is the medial view of the cerebral hemisphere, each hemisphere. Okay, so I have taken one hemisphere here. So now see the lateral sulcus. So let me draw the lateral sulcus with the green color. So now see, so this is the stem of lateral sulcus. So here it will lie. Okay, so stem is here. So there is, you will find the deep fissure. So which lies in the inferior surface, which separates the orbital surface from the tentorial surface. So this orbital and the tentorial part, so that is the part of inferior surface only. So in between this, so you will find the stem of lateral sulcus which run so for slightly forward and laterally. And see now this stem, so now it will reach up to here. Okay, so that point is the Sylvian point. So this notch is the, so that is due to the lateral stem of lateral sulcus only. Okay, now see it will reach here. After reaching here, what will happen? So after reaching here, this lateral sulcus, now it will divide. Okay, so one will go in front horizontally, so one will run so vertically upward, and one will run so the posteriorly. So see, this is the anterior horizontal rami. So this is the anterior ascending rami, and this is the posterior rami of lateral sulcus. Are you getting up to here? Now, next, let me draw the parieto-occipital sulcus. Now, here is the calcarine sulcus, so in the middle surface. So now see, from the midpoint of the calcarine sulcus, so the parieto-occipital sulcus will begin. Then it will reaches the which border? Superior medial border. Okay, because this sulcus, so that is the sulcus of medial surface. Now it will reaches up to here. So this here means, so it will reaches up to here somewhere maybe. Okay, so somewhere it will reach. So it means this distance, okay, so that from the occipital pole, so that is the 5 centimeter. So 5 centimeter in front of the occipital pole, the parieto-occipital sulcus reaches the, or cuts the superior medial border up to here. Now see, so from this, okay, so we cannot divide the, so this cerebral hemisphere into lobes. Okay, so there is the no complete division. Now see, we need the two extra thing. Okay, so that is the two imaginary line. So the two imaginary lines, so see the first imaginary line, so let me draw. So the first imaginary line, so let me draw with the pink color. So the first imaginary line, so you have to draw from here to, so this dot dot. So this represents the first imaginary line, and the second imaginary line, so this is like this. Okay, so now see, so the now see from where to where you have to draw the first imaginary line. So first imaginary line and the next second imaginary line. So minute. So the first imaginary line. So you have to draw from the point of termination. Okay, so you have to start to draw the first imaginary line. So from the termination of the parieto-occipital sulcus. So that means. So the first imaginary line so extend okay from the point okay 5 cm in front of the occipital pole in the superior medial border where the parieto occipital sulcus terminate and from there so you have to draw this line up to where so you have to find one notch in the inferior lateral border so this notch so that is the preoccipital notch so this preoccipital notch means just lies in front. Okay, so before the occipital pole, so almost 5 cm in front of the occipital pole in the inferior lateral border, so you'll find this notch. So you can see this slightly depression. So this up to this notch you have to draw. So this in this is the first imaginary line. So you have to join these 2 points. Okay, so then you will get the first imaginary line. Then the second imaginary line. So you have to start the second imaginary line from the termination of the posterior rami of the lateral sulcus. This is the posterior rami of lateral sulcus. So if you terminate here, then from here, so you have to draw the second imaginary line. So which should touch the first imaginary line. Okay. Now, so your lobes of the cerebral hemisphere will be like this. So now say this lobe. So that is the frontal lobe. Okay. So this lobe over here is the parietal lobe. So this lobe over here, so this is the temporal lobe. This lobe over here is the occipital lobe. Similarly, so this is the, so up to here it will be the, okay. So central sulcus will be here. So the frontal lobe is here. So parietal lobe will be here. Okay, so the temporal lobe will be here. Okay, so occipital lobe, so will be, so here. Okay, occipital lobe is here. Okay, just remember this thing. So then now, see, now the next is the insula. So this insula means to see the insula. So see, so this fissures, okay. So you have to separate, okay. So you have to pull this fissure, and this insula lies at the floor of lateral sulcus. So especially so that the posterior rami of lateral sulcus. So if you stretch, then you will see that, or if you separate the two lip or the two margin of the posterior rami of the lateral sulcus, okay, then you will see the insula in the floor of that sulcus. Okay, so let me show you here in the diagram also. So now see, so here, okay, so the two imaginary lines, so the same thing, so I have already mentioned. So from here, so you can see in this diagram also, so this dot line, okay, so this dot line, okay, so this is the first and here is the second imaginary line. So this yellow color is the temporal, so this is the occipital, so here is the parietal and here is the frontal. Okay, so just remember this thing. Now five lobe, you will see, to see the five lobe, so here see, frontal you have seen, so 1, temporal 2, parietal 3, occipital 4, so there are the 4 lobe and one more lobe, so to see one lobe, so you have to separate this lip. Okay, so here, so in this diagram, so I have shown you this lobe. Okay, so let me show you here, so insula, so here see, so the, see this is the posterior rami of the lateral sulcus. So it is separated by, see, so stretching this. So here, then you, inside you will see the insular lobe. Okay. So these are the lobe, okay, so related to the cerebral hemisphere. So now the different color area you can see in this diagram. So this is the frontal. So this yellow is the parietal. This is the temporal. This is the occipital. So this is the lateral view and then the medial view. So you can see this is the frontal is there, parietal is there, occipital is there, temporal is there. Okay. So now to see the insula. So now from here you have to stretch. Okay. So you have to separate this lip. So if you see, stretch this lip, then underneath, so you will see. Okay. So now this lobe is more visible in this diagram. Okay, now see. So this lobe is over here. So now see. So see. So this is the lateral fissure, isn't it? So now see, if you stretch this up, so you see some cortical tissue. So in the floor, so this part is the insula. Okay, so this is the insular part. So means, so that is cover up or operculated by. So now see, lead is formed. Okay, so lead is formed by this. Okay, frontal and this. Okay, so this frontal. Okay, and even the part of the temporal. Okay, so the frontal lobe especially. So there is the operculum. This is the pars opercularis is there. Operculum. So that is the lead. So lead is there. So to see the insula, so you have to remove this lead. So see, covering is. Okay, so the covering you have to separate. Okay, so you have got a pars opercularis is there. So regarding the frontal lobe, okay, so that forms the, this forms the overlapping actually. So it overlaps. So to see, so you have to open this overlapping. Then you will see the insular lobe inside. So this is the insula is here. So these are the lobes, okay, and the so major sulcus. And the imaginary line which divides the cerebral hemisphere into different lobes. Okay, so now in the next, so we will see the, so the sulcus and the gyrus in each lobe now. Okay, so the individual name of gyrus and the individual sulcus name, so we have to know. So see, so we have seen the major sulcus, isn't it? Sulcus and the fissures. So major sulcus and fissures we have seen, and we have seen the lobe present in the cerebral hemisphere. Okay, so here, so this is the major sulcus. Okay, so this is the central sulcus is here. Okay, so some part of the parieto-occipital sulcus is here. Okay, so and here you can see the stem of lateral sulcus, and the stem of lateral sulcus so divides into three. So this is the posterior rami. So anterior ascending rami, anterior horizontal rami. Okay, and so the two imaginary line are there. Okay, so the two imaginary line. So the first imaginary line. Okay, so you have to draw like this. So up to the preoccipital notch. Okay, and the next. So from this terminal end of the posterior rami of the lateral sulcus. So you have to draw the second imaginary line. So now you will get the lobe. Okay, so this is the frontal lobe now. So this frontal lobe, so that is present in front of the central sulcus and above the posterior rami of lateral sulcus. Here is the next lobe. So this is the temporal lobe. So the temporal lobe, so that is present just below the posterior rami of lateral sulcus, below the second imaginary line, and in front of the first imaginary line. So that is the temporal lobe. Similarly, so this lobe is the parietal lobe. So the parietal lobe, so that is present, okay, so behind the central sulcus and in front of the first imaginary line. Okay, so that is the parietal lobe, or the, so this lobe lies just above the second, that is the imaginary line also. Okay, so this region. Okay, so that is the parietal. So you can see the next lobe over here. So that is the occipital lobe. So the occipital lobe, so it lies behind the first imaginary line and behind the parieto-occipital sulcus. Okay, just behind this. Okay, so these are the, so the major lobe. And one more lobe is there. Okay, so if you spread this, okay, so if you separate this, if you pull this, okay, so the lip of the posterior rami of lateral sulcus, and you stretch it, then, or you open that, then you will see one lobe inside, buried inside this, okay, at the floor. So that is the insular lobe. Okay, so for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lobe you will see. Okay, so the fifth lobe is hidden. Okay, so it lies at the floor of the posterior rami of lateral fissure. Okay, in the floor you will see. So it is hidden lobe, so you have to open this lip and you will see. Okay, so these are the five lobes. So the frontal lobe is there, parietal lobe is there, occipital lobe is there, temporal lobe is there, and the insular lobe. And the pole is here. So anterior end of the frontal is the frontal pole, anterior end of the temporal lobe is the temporal pole, and next is the occipital pole. Okay, so the posterior pole. Okay, so this is the anterior, this is the posterior side. Okay, and the same thing. So if you observe from the medial surface or medial view, okay, so see, so now this is the medial surface. Okay, so initially that is the lateral view, now this is the medial view of the east cerebral hemisphere. Okay, cerebral hemisphere. Now see, so this, so this yellow color area, so this is the frontal lobe. This green color area, this is the parietal lobe. This blue color area, that is the temporal lobe. And this again yellow color behind, that is the occipital lobe. Okay, so from the medial side, so you will see this structure. And this red color area, so this is the corpus callosum only, so that is the white matter only. Okay, so these are the lobe. Okay, so you will see in the east cerebral hemisphere. Okay, so now we have to see the other sulcus and the fissures. Okay, so these are the major sulcus. Okay, so the major sulcus, central sulcus is there, lateral sulcus is there, parieto occipital sulcus is there. Okay, so they are the major. Now the various others, see, you can see the various, so this depression. Okay, then you can see this elevation. So these are the elevation. Okay, and the, this is the depression. Okay, so various depression are present and the various elevation are there. Okay, so the depression, they are the sulcus, and the elevation, they are the gyrus. Now we have to know the depression. So other depression, so and the individual name of this depression and the individual name of this elevation also, so we have to know. Okay, now let's see. Okay, so let's see the first superior lateral surface. Okay, so surface you already know, so the east cerebral hemisphere, so it has got three surfaces: superior lateral surface, medial surface, and the inferior surface. Okay, now we'll see the sulcus and gyrus present in the superior lateral surface. Okay, in the superior lateral surface means in this surface. Okay, so many gyrus and sulcus are present. Now we are going to name these. Okay, and again, so for our easiness, the superior lateral surface also will divide, okay, on the basis of lobe. So we'll see the sulcus and gyrus present in the frontal lobe, in superior lateral surface, in parietal lobe, in temporal lobe, and in occipital lobe. Okay, so for our easiness, okay, so because many are there, okay, so for our easiness, in superior lateral also, so we'll see the sulcus in the frontal, temporal, parietal, and occipital. Okay, so in individual lobe, in the superior lateral surface, so what are the sulcus and what are the gyrus present, so we'll see that. Okay, okay, up to here. Okay, now let's see the sulcus, okay, and gyrus present in first frontal lobe. Okay, so in the frontal lobe, in the superior lateral surface, so let's see in frontal lobe first. So in frontal lobe, okay, so in frontal lobe, okay, now see, so you already know the frontal lobe, so it lies just in front of the central sulcus. Okay, so means we have to see the gyrus and sulcus present in the just anterior to the central sulcus. Okay, so now see the sulcus, so just in front of the central sulcus. Central sulcus is the major only, because it divides the, so it separates the parietal lobe from the frontal lobe. Okay, so now see, so the sulcus here and the gyrus present in the frontal lobe. So first let me tell the gyrus here, because see, just in front of the central sulcus, okay, so you will find one gyrus. Gyrus is the raised portion. Okay, so the elevation, so that is the just in front, so it's the pre first to this, so that's the pre central gyrus. Okay, and just in front of the precentral gyrus, then you will find the precentral sulcus. Okay, so the precentral gyrus. Okay, so this is the gyrus. So just in front of the central sulcus, the gyrus present is the precentral gyrus. Just in front of, so just in front of the central sulcus, so you will find one gyrus. Okay, first let me draw here central sulcus. So this sulcus over here, so that is the central sulcus. Okay, now just in front of the central, so these are the major sulcus. Okay, so let me draw the major sulcus first. Okay, so let me draw the major sulcus here. Okay, so the major sulcus is in the red color. Okay, so forget this red color. Okay, don't see this red color, so which I have picked. Okay, don't see this one. So the central sulcus, now see, so just in front of the central sulcus, so that is the frontal lobe. Okay, now in the frontal lobe, so see here, so just in front of the central sulcus, you can see one raised part. So this portion, so this area. Okay, so this area, so this is the gyrus. So this is the precentral gyrus, and just in front of the precentral gyrus, so you will see again one depression. So this is the, that is the sulcus. So this is the precentral sulcus. Okay, so are you getting? So, and the area just in front of the precentral sulcus, so that is divided into three region or the three gyrus. Okay, by the help of two sulcus, so that is the superior frontal sulcus, and the next is the inferior frontal sulcus. So let me write here. So the frontal lobe, so we are saying in the superior lateral surface. Okay, so you will see the gyrus and the sulcus. Now see, so just in front of the frontal sulcus, central sulcus, you will see the gyrus, that is the precentral gyrus. And just behind, just in front again, so just front to the central sulcus, precentral gyrus, so you will see the sulcus. Okay, so that is the precentral sulcus. Are you getting up to here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so the red color sulcus, so that is the central sulcus, that is the major. Okay, so just in front of this, so you'll see the elevation, so that is the gyrus, that is the precentral gyrus. Just in front of this gyrus again, you will see the one depression. Okay, so which run parallel to the central sulcus. Okay, so that sulcus is the precentral sulcus. Now just in front of the precentral sulcus, now the area of frontal lobe, okay, so that is divided into three gyrus. Okay, by the help of two sulcus, so this is one sulcus, so this is the next sulcus. So this upper one is the superior frontal sulcus, the lower one is the inferior frontal sulcus. So let me write here. So you will find the next sulcus over here, that is the inferior and superior frontal sulcus. Okay, then you will see the inferior frontal sulcus. So now these two sulcus, okay, so divides the, so remaining area, so which is present just in front of the precentral sulcus, so this divides into three gyrus. Okay, so this gyrus, so they are superior frontal gyrus, so superior frontal gyrus, then you will find the middle frontal gyrus, the medial frontal gyrus you will see, then you will see the inferior frontal gyrus. Okay, so are you getting up to here? So now this gyrus, so you can see just above the superior frontal sulcus. So this gyrus is superior frontal gyrus, just below the superior frontal sulcus and just above the inferior frontal sulcus. So that means the in between the superior and the inferior frontal sulcus. So this gyrus is the middle frontal gyrus, and just below the inferior frontal sulcus, though this region of frontal lobe in the superior superior lateral surface. So this is the inferior frontal gyrus. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Now see, yes, again. Sir. So the inferior frontal gyrus, so it is again divided into three parts. Okay, now inferior frontal gyrus, it has got a three part, and these three parts, so that is divided by the rami of lateral sulcus. So here are the two rami, so that extend in this inferior frontal gyrus and divides the inferior frontal gyrus into three parts. Okay, so what are this sulcus first? So anterior horizontal rami, of lateral sulcus. Similarly, we have got a anterior ascending rami. Lateral sulcus. So two rami are there. Okay, so actually three rami are there from the lateral sulcus, but the two rami extend in this inferior frontal gyrus and divides the inferior frontal gyrus into three parts. Okay, so what are these three parts? So let me tell. So the inferior frontal. So gyrus, so that is divided into pars or vitalis, then pars or vitalis, pars triangularis, and the pars opercularis. So the pars opercularis. So the three regions, so you will see the three distinct regions. Okay, so the three distinct regions, so from the inferior gyrus, so you can see in the diagram also. Okay, so here you can see. So now let me draw the extension of the lateral. So see this lateral sulcus, so that the extension of the lateral sulcus. Okay, so this lateral sulcus extends so posteriorly as the posterior rami. So there you will find the one horizontal rami, so that is the anterior horizontal rami, and the next, so that is the anterior ascending rami. So can you see these three extension from the lateral sulcus or the lateral fissure? So this is the lateral stem of lateral fissure. So let me draw with the red color. So this is the stem of lateral fissure. Now this point is the Sylvian point from here. So the three extensions are there from the lateral fissure. So one will move in front, next will move ascend up along the frontal lobe. Okay, so these two are the anterior horizontal rami and the anterior ascending rami. Now see, due to presence of these two sulcus, okay, so the inferior frontal gyrus, so that is divided into, so this whole is the inferior frontal gyrus. Now due to presence of these two sulcus, okay, so this inferior frontal gyrus, so it has got a three area. So this area, so that is the this area, okay, just below the anterior horizontal rami. So this portion, that is the pars orbitalis, in between these two two rami, so that is in between the anterior horizontal rami and the anterior ascending rami. So you'll find the pars triangularis, and just behind the anterior ascending rami, so the area, so that is the pars opercularis. Okay, so the pars opercularis just behind the anterior horizontal rami, and the area just in front or just below the anterior horizontal rami, that is the pars orbitalis, and the region between the anterior horizontal rami and the anterior ascending rami. So the shape of this gyrus is triangular in shape with the pars triangularis. So this is the pars triangularis. So this is the pars orbitalis. This is the pars opercularis. See, opercularis means operculum, so means is the lead. So it forms the lead. Okay. Why lead? See, so if you remove this lead, or if you reflect this lead, so you will see one more lobe inside that. So that is the insula. Okay, the insula. Okay. So opercularis means, operculum means lead. Okay. So if you remove that lead, so underneath you will see the insular lobe. Okay. So name is like that. Okay. So once again, so let me tell you, so in the diagram, so let me draw here. So the brain, suppose this is the, so suppose this is the simple diagram of, okay, so cerebral hemisphere. Now see, so this is the stem of lateral, so let me draw the major sulcus with the red color. So stem of lateral sulcus will come up to here. Now, so here is the central sulcus is here. So let me draw the central sulcus also. So here is the central sulcus. So up to here, so the parieto-occipital sulcus will come. Okay. Now, so let me draw the, so other sulcus now. Okay. So present in the frontal. So here is the frontal lobe is here. Okay. Just in front of the central sulcus is the frontal. Okay. So we are concerning about the frontal lobe only. Now see, so just in front of the central sulcus, okay, so you will find the elevated area, so that is the pre-central gyrus. So here is the pre-central gyrus. Just in front of the pre-central gyrus, so you will see one sulcus. So that is the, this sulcus is the pre-central sulcus. So pre-central sulcus. PCS is the precentral sulcus. Okay, so precentral sulcus. So this is the precentral. Now see, precentral gyrus means in between the precentral sulcus and the central sulcus. Okay, so this is the central sulcus. So central sulcus, parieto occipital sulcus. So this is the lateral fissure. Okay, so now see, the area of the frontal lobe, just in front of the precentral sulcus, so it is divided into three gyrus by the presence of two sulcus. So this two sulcus, so that is the superior frontal sulcus. Next is the inferior frontal sulcus. Okay. Now the gyrus, so that is present here. So let me name the gyrus with the different color so that you can understand. So here, so let me write here. So this is the, so here is the pre-central gyrus. Now see, so this front, superior frontal sulcus and inferior frontal sulcus, so divides the area, so present just in front of the precentral sulcus into three gyrus. So this is the superior frontal gyrus, this is the medial frontal gyrus, and remaining this one is the inferior frontal gyrus. Now see, if you see the inferior frontal gyrus, so again, so it has got a division. Okay, so now there is the presence of other sulcus. Now see, so if you see the lateral fissure, okay, so now this lateral fissures from the Sylvian point, it will split into three. So means, so one rami, so it will move forward. So one rami, so it will move forward and upward. So one rami, so it will move posteriorly. Okay, now see, so this one is, so this is the anterior horizontal rami. So anterior horizontal rami of lateral fissure. Just you write. So this one is the, so So let me give arrow here. So this one is the anterior ascending rami of lateral fissure. Now this is the posterior rami of lateral fissure. Okay. So now see. So due to the presence of these two, anterior horizontal rami and the anterior ascending rami, now the inferior frontal gyrus is divided into three region, three part. So these three parts. So this is so just below this rami. Okay. So this area over here. So this is the pars orbitalis, and the area between these two. So this area between two. So this area over here. So these are the this area is the pars triangularis, and the region behind the anterior ascending rami. So this region over here. So this region over here, so that is the pars opercularis. Are you getting up to here? So these are the sulcus and fissures so present in the superior lateral surface of frontal lobe. Okay, so thus you can draw this simple diagram. Okay, so thus you make a simple diagram and you can label there only. Okay, so that will be easy for you also. Then the next, now let's see the sulcus and the gyrus, so that is present within the temporal lobe. Okay, then we'll see the parietal lobe, because so some sulcus present in the temporal lobe, so some posterior in the extent up to the parietal lobe also. So we'll see the first temporal lobe, then we'll see the parietal lobe. Okay, so now see, so now we are going to see the sulcus and the fissures present in this lobe. Okay, so this lobe is the temporal lobe. Okay, so we have already seen the frontal lobe. Okay, so in the superior lateral surface on the temporal lobe, so you will find the three sulcus. Okay, so the three sulcus you will see, and the three gyrus. Okay, name is easy actually. So here, so you'll find the three sulcus and the so including this. Okay, so including the posterior rami, I am telling. Okay, so actually you'll see two only, but including this posterior rami. Here I am mentioning the posterior rami also, because posterior rami that forms the partition only. Okay, so here see, so in the superior lateral surface in the temporal lobe, sulcus. So you will see the sulcus. So that is the temporal sulcus. Next, you will see the sulcus. Okay. Now see here. So this posterior rami of lateral sulcus, okay, so actually it forms the partition. Okay, so it forms the boundary between the anterior and the temporal. Okay, so I am not mentioning this rami over here. Okay, but the posterior end will come in the parietal also. Okay, now just you remember here, so the posterior rami of the lateral sulcus, so this separates the frontal lobe from the temporal lobe. Okay, just remember this thing here, no need to write. So these are the, so major sulcus, so you see, so the sulcus, okay, so present in the temporal lobe. So you'll see the superior temporal and the inferior temporal. Okay, whereas the this posterior rami of the lateral fissure, so that separates the frontal lobe from the temporal lobe. Okay, and also some part, okay, so it separates from the parietal also. Okay, parietal lobe is it, because just above the posterior rami is the posteriorly is the parietal, anteriorly there is the frontal. Okay, and inferiorly you will see the temporal. Now the gyrus, so here you will find the three gyrus now. Okay, so two sulcus, okay, just above the superior temporal sulcus, so the gyrus present is the superior, and in between the superior and inferior temporal sulcus, that is the medial, and just below the inferior temporal, below the inferior temporal sulcus, so that is the inferior temporal. Inferior temporal, so gyrus. So see, so this is the superior temporal sulcus. So here is the superior temporal sulcus. So here is the inferior temporal sulcus. Okay, now see, these all sulcus, they have got a upturned portion, means so it will run horizontally, and the terminal portion, so it will turn up. So they are the upturned portion. So this upturned portion, so it extend in the parietal lobe. Okay, so just remember. And here is the posterior rami of lateral sulcus. Now see, so the sulcus, they will move like this, and the terminal part, so they will form like this. So they will run like this, like this. So they will have got a upturn in. Okay, just remember. So now see, so this two major is two. Okay, so this just forms the partition between this. So here is the one lobe, so here is the one lobe, so here is the one lobe. So it's from this posterior rami from the partition. So now see, one, two sulcus, so they are present in the temporal lobe. Now the gyrus, so you will see that is the, so here see, so this is the superior temporal gyrus, the middle temporal gyrus, and here is the inferior temporal gyrus. Okay, so the three gyrus you will see here. Okay, are you getting up to here? Okay, so I'll draw one diagram and it will be more clear for you. Okay, before that, so let me explain the parietal lobe also. So together I'll show you, okay, in diagram. So now let's see the parietal lobe. Okay, so in the superior lateral surface, so we are seeing in the superior lateral only. Okay, we are not seeing in the medial surface. Okay, so in the medial surface, so okay, so other are also there. So in the superior lateral surface of the parietal lobe, so you will see the parietal lobe. So now see, so let me write the first. Okay, so anything you can write. So sulcus, so sulcus, so you will see the post central. Now it is behind, so it's the post. Post central intra parietal. So intra parietal is there, and even so you can see the upturn end of the, so upturn end of the, so actually these sulcus, so they are the of temporal lobe. Okay, but so the terminal end, okay, so they are there. So let me write here upturn end only. So upturn end of the posterior rami of lateral fissure. So similarly the superior temporal sulcus, and they are the upturned end only. Okay, so the terminal end only. Then the next one, so that is the inferior temporal sulcus. So they are the upturned portion of this sulcus. So you will see in this. In this means in this parietal lobe. Okay, so just remember the name. So I'll show in the diagram. So next is the gyrus. If you see the gyrus, okay, so you will see the post central gyrus, then you will see the superior parietal lobule, next one is the inferior lobule, and see, even so the inferior parietal lobule, so again, so it has got a parts. Okay, so first let me show you in the diagram, then I'll tell the parts. Okay, so again this inferior parietal lobule, so it is again, so it has got a three parts or the three regions. Okay, so anterior, middle, and the posterior region is there. So the anterior region is the GY RUS gyrus. Then the next is the our posterior region or part. Okay, so supramarginal gyrus, that is the anterior part of infraparietal lobule. So this is the middle part. Okay, now let me show you this thing in the diagram. So now together I will show you. Okay, so in the parietal and the temporal lobe. Okay, so together I will show you. So now see in this diagram, then I will draw one diagram. Now see here. So here is the central sulcus. Okay, so these are the major sulcus only. Okay, now see. So the posterior rami. So now it is running so horizontally, but see the terminal part, so it will turn up. So it's the upturned portion. So here you can see the superior temporal sulcus. Okay, so it's running like this horizontally almost, but the terminal end so turn up. So similarly, the terminal end of the inferior temporal also turn up like this. Okay, so now we are seeing the parietal. Okay, so in the parietal lobe, so you can see the sulcus. So that is the post central sulcus. So this is the post central sulcus. And the region between the post central sulcus and the central sulcus, so this is the gyrus. So this is the post central gyrus. So this is the post central gyrus, and this sulcus is the post central sulcus. Now the region behind the post central sulcus, the part of the parietal lobe is divided into two lobules by the help of intraparietal sulcus. The intraparietal sulcus divides the posterior portion of the post central sulcus. So means that the area behind the post central sulcus is divided into two area. So that is, one is the superior parietal lobule, next is the just below this interparietal sulcus. So this is the inferior parietal lobule. Now this inferior parietal lobule, so it has got a three part from front to behind or from front to back. So now see, so the area, so along the upturned portion of this rami, so this is the anterior. And the area along the upturned portion of the superior temporal sulcus, so that is the middle area. And the area along the upturned portion of the inferior temporal sulcus, this is the posterior area. Okay, now see, so the anterior area, so that is the supramarginal gyrus. The middle area is the middle area. So this is the angular gyrus and the posterior area. Okay, are the posterior region. So these are the gyrus. Okay, so supramarginal gyrus, then angular gyrus, then next one is the posterior part or the posterior area. Okay, so these three area in the inferior parietal lobule and the superior parietal lobule, and the next gyrus, so that is the post central gyrus. Now the sulcus are, this is the post central sulcus. So the post central sulcus, then the interparietal sulcus and the upturned portion only. So this upturned portion of these three, so that is the posterior rami of lateral fissure. Okay, then the upturned portion of the superior temporal gyrus, superior temporal sulcus, upturned portion of inferior temporal sulcus. So this portion, so this lies in the parietal, lobe. Okay, here, so no need to mention this upturned portion here. Okay, so I have mentioned this upturned portion to show you the three division of the inferior parietal lobe. Actually this sulcus, okay, they are not the sulcus of parietal lobe. Okay, they are the sulcus from the temporal lobe only. Okay, so this is superior, this is the inferior, they are the sulcus here only this terminal end is here. Okay, so no need to mention this sulcus over here. Are you okay? Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let me show you this thing in the simple diagram, and you can copy that diagram. So, suppose. So this is the frontal lobe is here. So here is the suppose temporal lobe is here. So suppose this is the occipital lobe. Okay. So for Now see, so here is the stem of lateral fissure. Okay, so the stem of lateral fissure. So now see, it is split into three lamina. So you already know this thing. Now here is the posterior lamina. So it will upturn portion is here. So now here is the central sulcus. Let me draw here central sulcus. The central sulcus is over here. And so let me draw here the parieto-occipital sulcus also. Okay. Now, so I'll show the major features and the sulcus present in the temporal and the parietal. Okay. So name of this major sulcus. Okay, you already know. Okay. Now I'm not giving the name. So now I'm making the sulcus present in the temporal lobe with the green color. So now see. So this is the one sulcus. So that is the superior temporal sulcus. So the next sulcus over here. So this is the inferior temporal sulcus. So these are the upturned portion. So these are the upturned portion only. Okay. So now this sulcus, so they divides the temporal, okay, so region, okay, into three areas. So that is the superior temporal gyrus, middle temporal gyrus, and the inferior temporal gyrus. Okay. So let me write the name of the gyrus. So this is the superior temporal gyrus, middle temporal gyrus, then next one is the inferior temporal gyrus. Inferior temporal gyrus, superior temporal, and the middle temporal gyrus. And the sulcus are superior temporal sulcus, mid and inferior temporal sulcus. So two sulcus. Okay. So here the superior temporal sulcus. Similarly, inferior temporal sulcus. Okay, so this is in the temporal. Okay, so here we are seeing the superior lateral surface only. So superior lateral surface. Okay, in the temporal lobe we are seeing. Now see, let's see in the parietal lobe. So parietal lobe, let me draw with the different color. Okay, brown color. Okay, now see, just behind the central sulcus, so you will see the gyrus. So that is the, so behind is the post. So is the post central gyrus. Just behind. So this red color is the central sulcus. Okay. So let me write here. So this is the central sulcus. Thus the reason behind or the gyrus just present behind the central sulcus. This is the post central gyrus. So the post central gyrus. And thus behind the post central gyrus. So you will see the sulcus. Okay. So let me draw the sulcus. So just behind this, so you will see sulcus. So that is the post central sulcus. So this is the supposed post central sulcus. So this is the post central sulcus. Post central sulcus. Now the area of parietal lobe, thus behind the post central sulcus, is divided into two lobules. So that you can see one sulcus, that is the intraparietal sulcus. So suppose this is the intraparietal sulcus. So suppose this is the intraparietal sulcus. So intraparietal sulcus now divides the region, okay, present just behind the post central sulcus into two. Okay, so superior and inferior. So now this sulcus, that is the intraparietal sulcus. Now the lobule, so present over here, so that is the superior parietal lobule, and next one is the below one is the inferior parietal lobule. Okay, are you getting? So now see this inferior parietal lobule. Okay, now again, so it has got a three region. Okay, so one region, so around this upturned portion of the posterior rami of lateral fissure. Next region, that is the middle region around this upturned portion of this superior temporal sulcus, and the posterior region, so just around the upturned portion of the inferior temporal sulcus. So these are the anterior, middle, and the posterior area of inferior parietal lobe. Okay, so now they have got a name. So one is the this, now they have got a name. So this anterior one is the supramarginal gyrus, the middle one is the angular gyrus, and the next one, so that is the posterior area or the posterior part. Are you getting up to here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, see in the frontal also. So here is the, so the gyruses in front of the central, that is the pre-central gyrus. Now the sulcus is the pre-central sulcus. Then the just area be just in front of the pre-central sulcus divided into three area by the two gyrus, that is the superior frontal gyrus and the inferior frontal gyrus. Then inferior front, this is the superior frontal gyrus. Inferior frontal as the middle frontal, so this is the middle. So let me write with a different color. So see this blue color, so that is the pre-central sulcus, okay, and the area just in front of the pre-central sulcus. So this is divided into three region or the three gyrus by the superior frontal gyrus and inferior frontal gyrus and sulcus, not gyrus, that one. So this is the sulcus. So this is the sulcus. Okay, the elevation is the gyrus. So now see the gyrus over here, you will see they are, so here is the superior frontal gyrus. Okay, so elevation is gyrus. So middle frontal gyrus, and here is the inferior frontal gyrus. Okay, so now this region here, so that is the pre-central gyrus. So not frontal, this one is the pre-central gyrus is here. Okay, now see the inferior frontal gyrus, again the three regions are there. Okay, so here is the pars orbitalis, pars triangularis, and the pars opercularis. Okay, so now this inferior frontal gyrus, so okay, so divided into three gyrus, so due to the presence of anterior horizontal rami of lateral fissure and the anterior ascending fissures of the anterior ascending rami of the lateral fissure. Okay, so this is about the, so gyrus sulcus are present in the, so frontal, temporal, and the parietal lobe. Now we have got occipital lobe, so we'll see this tomorrow.